You're inside Brunch on a Sunday morning. Our follow-up guest is not currently here, and my guests, thank goodness, have agreed to extend their time because there are a lot of areas that we still have to cover. I did want to come back with something before I get back to Ramash. I want to go to the Economist for a moment. That's Omardath Maharaj. In the area that the PNM Manifesto seeks to increase agricultural contribution to the gross domestic product from 0.6% to 3%, or a 20% increase over 5 years. That is 4% per year. From what we see they are putting into this effort, do you think we will get that return of investment on investment? In other words, we are expecting so-and-so. Are we putting in the necessary things to acquire that goal or to reach that goal?
Well, experience speaks a lot as we go forward, right? The medium-term policy framework 2011-2014 set targets for the agriculture sector. We also, in the medium-term policy framework, set out to move the agriculture contribution to GDP from 0.5% to a certain similar percentage. We set out about food price inflation, employment in the sector, and all these things. 5 years down the line, we really are far cry from what the medium-term policy framework 2011-2014 identified as targets for Trinidad and Tobago. All right? So we here at this door again with a similar disposition. And we spoke to the minister, was saying that he cannot scamp out in the first year to run and increase production. Right? Increasing production to go where we made all that discussion. And he identified structure, governance, and people, and getting the right machinery in place. Because within that rate of investment we talk about, there are a lot of wastage and inefficiency. And a lot of people on the job who drop in the ball, as they say, and whatnot, whatnot. Within the last 4 months, we saw the appointment of an economic advisory board. There's an energy industry steering committee. I saw last week the cabinet appointed a high-level team as a tourism industry steering committee. So without preempting the minister, there may be, in fact, an agriculture or food production steering committee on the pipe for Trinidad and Tobago. And that committee, if we could just get involved in that conversation, if it is we're looking at the main contributors within the sector, the industries, and what is critical to the man on the street, and if we follow through in some of the conversations that the minister has been saying, if we follow through with that line of thinking, nothing prohibits the appointment of such a committee or the involvement of all these players. And that committee clearly, as our conversation in summary has been going, it needs to have a health perspective, a production, a farmer's input, education, rural development, which is another pillar of this government. A new ministry has been formed. So you need to have these universal views coming into the thing. And I think that in terms of governance and managing the sector, and so yes, we want to increase agriculture's contribution to GDP, but we also need to retool the efficiency of the sector to produce that.
Love the contribution that you make there. You talk about a collaboration at the end of the day. That's what we've been doing here all morning, and coordination. The area of vegetable and root production is something that must come together with the fruit and vegetable farmers. What is going on with that? Are there any obstacles, or are there any ways we can improve on bringing together these two sectors of agriculture?
Well, Mr. Bishop, our root crop, vegetables, you know, fruits, etc., we need to have a coordination. But I know time is running out, right? And on this table right now, you know, there's a lot of challenges with respect to our food security, what we eat, what we don't eat, what we import, what we do import, etc., etc. But right here this morning, I just want to let you know that we have the solution right here. This is a challenge and this is a solution. The solution is that in each backyard, we could plant these things here. Each backyard, every single backyard in Trinidad and Tobago that is available. All right? Dashin bush, tania. We have lemon. We have citrus, Portugals. We have our coconut. There's the fat on coconut on oil, on some oils. I understand soya may not be as nutritious as maybe some other oils. So if we make our own local oil, the world is the best oil in the world. We have pomsite, we have yam, we can make yam roti. We have cassava, okay, we can make our flour. We have pineapple, I brought here sugar cane. This is the sugar cane, and we have this leaf here is the palmis, okay, and I'm just showing you just the tip of the iceberg. And we have some rice there, we have some hill rice. the Creole rice from Moruga, all right? And all of this now, we have the Sahara relief. The message here is that in the Eat Local campaign just a few weeks ago, the TPFA sent a message that the backyard is the solution. What we plant, what we nurture, what we grow in our backyard, that mm-hmm. is the future for our forex challenges and our health challenges. Mr. Bishop, it's amazing to know that in Trinidad and Tobago, we have the best root crop. We have the best fruits. We have the best livestock, the shrimps in the world.
But yet still,
why it is the stats show that we are the most unhealthy nation? Why? And I want to end by saying this, that yes, our leaders, our professors, etc., our economists are speaking in this country. But we have to go beyond speaking. We have to live that be local life. And I want to thank you, Mr. Bishop. I want to thank your team. I want to thank 107.7. I want to thank social media. Facebook today, social media is a powerful tool. And we in Trinidad and Tobago are a cultured people. We brought ourselves into the situation that we in, and we have the culture to get ourselves out.
You yourself on Facebook, so folks can go up and simply type Pineapple Association and
Ramash Ramsumair and Amin and other people, Mr. Bishop, I would like to join and let us carry on this conversation for our children and our grandchildren. Unlike Mr. Maduro did just hours ago, for the next 2 months he has taken over Venezuela. All right, we don't want to go there, but they are our neighbors. In Trinidad and Tobago, we say that when your house is on fire, you wet yours, but we have to go a bit further. The TPFA and the farmer says that you don't have to wet your house alone, you have to wet other houses. This is what Trinidad and Tobago is about. So let us really be local for Carnival. Let us be local. Let us. We sing in local. We need the Forex to come in. We need our partners from away to come in. All right? But we have to really, for Christmas, we tried as much as possible. There was talks about we didn't have enough local toys and whatnot, but Trinidad and Tobago Carnival is upon us. Let us try with our parties, etc. We know that you will complain that you're not getting much pineapples, etc., etc. But let us try and use Carnival as a catalyst to move on for the balance of 2016 and be local.
Ramash Ramsumair, the president of the Pineapple Association. Very eloquent. Thank you so much for being with us this morning. And let me take it across to the agricultural economist and your closing comments on this, Omardath.
Just to close off, Rennie, we are a small island developing state, right? Jump high, jump low. We must import some critical mass, but they are essentials and they are non-essentials. And whereas the non-essentials are concerned, even where the essential imports are concerned, in the food and beverage industry, we can look for alternatives that our neighbors have for sale and that they are producing so that we do not have to spend that money, spend the forex dollars to support the agriculture of some other person in some other part of the world. And just to close off, we, or my personal message as well as on behalf of this farming group, is that yes, you want people to buy local, eat local, drink local, but our message for 2016 was to be local. And be local is this patriotic tone that the Minister of Trade felt that she, the spirit met, as they say, but the fact is, this conversation is not only about what we eat and what we do, but if it is you listen to for music, you're a man in the industry, and you buy all these foreign CDs and all whatever. The fact is, there are local artists who need the support. Everything that we bring in here, there's somebody on the ground who needs the support. And that's where this idea of being local comes about. So that, yes, you have carnivores who eat meat, omnivores, herbivores, whatever. We are now promoting locavores. Right? Let us support everything that's being Trinidad and Tobago and bring this mother earth back to where she was.
And if they go to the Tableland Pineapple Farmers Association Facebook page, you'll get a lot of this message available to them.
Surely.
As I did, I went to your page, and at your page, there's still the message, the same thing. All right? Omardath Maharaj and, of course, Ramesh, thank you all both for being here this morning. Truly appreciate it. We must do this some more. Must do this with more, a little more time. And next time, I'll just probably schedule you all in for the 2 hours. Have yourself a wonderful day.
Thank you.